So another parameter of soil sample, that is relative density. So here is the test for relative density by vibrating table. So here is the relative density mold, and there is a surcharge load of around 25 kg, and here is the guide cylinder and a S plate. And for this test, we required a cohesionless soil duly passed through 4.75 mm sieve. So let us know first of all some data to be collected before going to the test. First of all, we will take the empty weight of this mold, that is weight 1, W1. And we'll note down the reading. Next, I must take the volume of this mold. So as it is a cylindrical type mold, so we require the height and dia. Next, we'll pour this sand into the mold with the help of a sand pouring funnel at a height of 25 mm maximum. So that will be our loosest state of density inside the mold. So we'll pour this soil sample into this funnel, and with a lower height of maximum 25 mm max. Here is the method of pouring the sand inside the mold from outer to center in a circular motion. We'll fill this mold gradually. And you must notice that, make sure the height of fall of the sand must not exceed above 25 mm. So now the surplus mass of the sand upon the mold to be removed by a straight edge. So as the upper surface should be plane as parallel to the mold. Take again weight of the mold along with the sand, that is weight 2, W2. So by deducting this from the whole mass to the weight of the cylinder, we can get the W3, that is weight of the dry soil. Now fix the mold into the vibrating table and fix it by knot very strongly. Next, place the surface plate upon the soil mass. Next, fix the guide cylinder upon it. Fix the guide cylinder upon this bolt like this way, and tight the cylinder with nut and as it is a vibrating table, so it required a locking knot, so it must be tightened properly. And after that, we will put this surcharge load upon this upon the mold. As it is very heavy iron mass, so safety precaution to be taken, and you must hold from handle only, not any elsewhere, because it is a heavy mass and required more effort to put into the mold. Our setup has been done. Now we will go for the switch on to the machine. Machine getting vibrating, and we will provide vibration up to 8 minutes. So after 8 minutes, we'll remove this surcharge load. And unclamp this screw and remove the upper cylinder also. So now this remove the surface plate. So you see the soil has been displaced already, and there is a change in depth due to the vibration. So we'll measure all this depth by help of a scale, by taking various from various corners to the mean. Now we will go for the mean depth. So by taking various depth, will find the mean depth. Getting reduced height of soil in mold after completion of the vibration, we can able to calculate the volume of the soil after completion of the vibration. We have to repeat this test for 3 times. So as we can able to get gamma mean, gamma max, E mean, and as per our formula, we can able to calculate the relative density of cohesionless soil sample.